Though some of what's happening is familiar, history doesn't provide examples of countries just being snuffed out by a giant collective brain fart. I'm beginning to see why Trumpism was likely, though unexpected. I'll explain it in a sci-fi fable. Once upon a time, there was a species on a faraway planet that evolved the power of language, and with it, imagination. It was very exciting to wake up to all the possibilities they could imagine, but also a little unsettling, because they could imagine anything, and a lot of what they imagined was hard to digest. Given their weird alien physiology, their indigestion was relieved through noxious burps that we might call brain farts. Not senior moment lapses, though related, basically an inability to keep up with the rate of disturbing possibilities flooding their minds. Like the kind of blurting we do when we're frustrated at being overwhelmed and thwarted. That kind of, oh hell no, I'm not taking any more of this bullshit, from now on I'm in charge. You know, that stuff we feel like blurting when we're losing control of our situation and demand it back. Their brain farts came in many flavors. Tantrums, scolding, seething, moralizing, pouting, playing victim. It was all sadonarcissistic. I'm good, anyone in my way is evil. You could call it blame fartings. I'm sick of being pushed around and it's all your fault. The beings got relief from their own brain farts. Their indigestion would subside when they off-gassed like that. But any beings nearby found it noxious. Well, not always. These alien beings would jump on each other's brain fart bandwagons when they vented the same frustrations. The brain farts became a mating signal. Two beings were likely to couple over common brain farts, the way human couples bond over shared frustrations and trash-talking others. You know, like the Bee Gees line, 'cause we're living in a world of fools breaking us up. And of course, couples would break up when their brain farts vented frustration at each other. When one partner's indigestion-relieving perfume became the other partner's noxious stench, they'd often break up and go off to mate with others who brain farted about their frustrations with their exes. The brain farts were also tribal mating calls, like pheromones in social organisms here on Earth. Tribes bonded over the pleasantness of their brain farts and the noxiousness of other tribes' brain farts. They'd vie for territory, more room to grow their tribe, and more distance from other tribes' noxious stench. Tribes would banish and even kill beings whose brain farts were noxious. There were a lot of brain fart wars over territory, but motivated by frustration with the enemy tribe's brain farts. Tribal leaders were often chosen on the pleasantness of their brain farts to the tribe members, and their noxiousness to competing tribes. As leaders competed for power within and between tribes, the brain farts got more and more elaborate and intense, more pleasant to one tribe and more noxious to other tribes. Leaders would brain fart that some imaginable being who presided over the universe preferred their brain farts best and found the brain farts of competing tribes so noxious that the imaginable being wanted them killed. None of this was true. In fact, the brain farts were blowing a hole in the ozone layer that covered their planet and protected them from the elements. The brain farts were causing all sorts of problems, including climate change, even putting the planet at risk of becoming uninhabitable for this species and other species they depended upon. Some tribes foresaw the problem their brain farts were causing. That possibility made their indigestion worse. And all the while, some of the beings were using their imagination to invent new tools that made their lives easier. Their frustration-reducing technologies reduced brain fart frustration, but also raised the beings' expectations. They'd get addicted to the tools, which would fail sometimes, causing even greater frustration and therefore brain farting. They'd also compete over the tools, which added to the overall brain farting. On top of that, many of the tools made brain farting much easier. Weapons, communication tech, eventually computers, which made it possible to send targeted brain farts to tribes far away. They eventually developed AI too, which many of these alien beings used to amp up their brain farts for extra sweetness to them and extra noxiousness to others. There were attempts to curb the brain farts, though mostly from frustrated brain farters complaining about other tribes' brain farts, like their farts didn't stink. And all the while, they were turning their brain farts into ever more credible fictions. At first, religious storytelling, but eventually movies, vivid fictions, in which there were heroes who, like gods, were always pure, right, righteous, and mighty, who never brain farted and stopped or killed all the bad brain farters. Entertainment became a great way to brain fart safely. They'd watch a movie, root for the heroes, as if, for sure, the heroes were on their side. They'd off-gas their indigestion, and when the movies were over, they'd get back to reality. Still, many of the beings ignored that the movies were fiction, the way many ignored that their religions were fiction. They'd go out brain farting as if their fictional heroes were their real-world allies. Insult them and you were insulting the heroes. So as with religion, it was their duty to vent their brain farts as noxiously as possible to kill the evil enemies. Things got dire on this planet. One hero playing leader after another brain farting at all rivals. By now, the ozone hole was getting bigger and bigger from all that brain farting, and the climate was changing rapidly, which gave a lot of people indigestion. Brain farting was on the rise throughout the species. There was this one tribe that by dumb luck had ended up with the best resources and technology, which they assumed proved that their brain farts were the best and most pleasing to God. They had long gotten away with most brain farting, especially because their technology was so good that they expected a lot and were easily frustrated. They ended up choosing an enterprising leader who was nothing but a hero playing brain farter. He hired all the most vocal brain farters. Together, they made enough of his tribe members feel like he was their hero, always on their side, and anyone whose brain farts bothered them was evil. This leader and his expert brain fart partners ended up taking control of all of the tribe's power. To enough of the frustrated members of his growing tribe, it was the most exciting smell they'd ever smelled. They giggle ecstatically whenever he brain farted. They learned to brain fart just like him. It was like the perfect relief to all of their indigestion, especially because the stench repulsed other members of their species. They brain farted in concert with this leader to add to the delicious stench. They rejoiced in feeling like heroes for all eternity. Their brain farts were like a drug that made them feel like the only problem in the world was that they weren't in charge. They didn't care about the growing ozone hole leaving them vulnerable. They didn't care about climate change becoming an ever greater cause of frustration because they were in la-la land, drugged out on their own brain farts, which they spewed even when they didn't have indigestion. The brain fart wars escalated across their planet. In some cases, it was hard to tell whether it was brain farts or the stench of brain-dead decay. It was getting bad. The more the species brain farted, the more uninhabitable their planet became. The more uninhabitable, the more the beings' frustrations increased. The more their frustrations increased, the more everyone brain farted. The more everyone brain farted, the more uninhabitable the planet became. And that did it. Their tribe didn't last long after that, snuffed out by brain farts. The other tribes followed soon after. Having learned this one master brain farter secret, it was a brain fart death spiral. The species went extinct. We only know about it by the record they left behind. Much of it records the brain farts that they came to regard as sacred. Thank heaven that isn't us, yet, though it could be any time. What can you do to prevent a brain fart death spiral here on planet Earth? I suggest a few things. Work on getting better at venting your brain fart frustrations safely in fiction, or what I call off-jerking, which is an alternative to being a jerk-off in public, enjoying your brain farts at other people's expense. It's simple. Just remember that they're fiction. Like when you get off on moralizing revenge porn on TV, in church, or wherever you off-jerk. When the show's over, zip up and get back to reality. Don't pretend that your imaginable heroes are your allies and that anyone who offends you is offending them. And don't pretend you don't brain fart because it doesn't smell bad to you. We all have to process our overwhelm and indigestion somehow. And get better at figuring out how to deal with other people's brain farts. Sometimes that means leaving the room. Sometimes it means tolerating theirs as they tolerate yours. And sometimes it means giving them a hard time without turning that into your brain fart about how everybody's brain farts stink but yours. It's not hard. It's merely essential for our survival. If you find yourself dealing with someone's unbearable stench, email me. I've got two ways to help. A free study group that is working on better ways to deal with other people's brain farts, especially the Trumpies, which are by now so thick they're clouding everyone's vision. And private strategic consulting, like if you're dealing with family, friends, coworkers who are making your life unbearable with their brain farts. Thank you.